Welcome back, Death by Metal. That was some God Forbid right there. One of my all-time favorites, too.
Oh, yeah. Excellent stuff, man. That is a true classic. No doubt about it.
Oh, yeah. Totally agree with you.
No, I just sent the wrong ball. Oh, man. Gives me
ball
a segue.
Ball in hand.
You know, old Yngwie Malmsteen back in the day, don't you, Larry?
Oh, yeah, the dick with fingers.
Oh, shit. Well, you know, he's in the news lately. You know, he's got a brand new album. And it's going to be, the album's going to be called Relentless. And it's out November 22nd. And it's on his own label, Rising Force Records. And Ripper Owens is doing some singing on this sucker.
Yep.
It's like his last album, Perpetual Flame.
Yep.
And so that's going to be interesting, just hearing Ripper on that. And it's, you know, this is an interesting thing. Time Magazine recognizing Bay as one of the top 10 guitarists of all time. That is quite cool. And with, you know, with the likes of, you know, Les Paul, Jimmy Page, and Hendrix, you know.
Right. Sounds like somebody may have done the research a little bit.
I think so. And you know, he has a new DVD out that came out back in June 29th. And it's called Raw Live. You know, it spans his career from, you know, 1981 through 99. And he includes his rare footage of his early years in Sweden, you know, personal interviews, and try to give him a little personal touch to his stuff, you know, just give him a little personality, of course, you know. When he's out in public, he's such a pompous ass and don't want to talk to nobody, you know, so this is his way of actually becoming more personal for a fan in his own right, you know, instead of, you know, making fun of him because he's such a bastard when he's out in public. You know, wants, you know, get his attention and then just walk away and try not to be a dick. So, you know, it's cool that, you know, Yngwie decides he's gonna do this for our Board of Horse fans. So, you know, that's cool, though. You know, so we'll give him credit for that. So, yeah, I haven't heard much Yngwie since Riding Forest back in late 80s, I think, when it came out.
I don't even know.
I remember hearing that album. That was fantastic. And I did see him open up for AC/DC back in 86. He came out with that. You know, he just blew me away. It was a great, great show. I mean, don't get me wrong, I was mesmerized by playing. You know, it was, you're in the presence of greatness. You know, and you knew that.
Right.
So that was one privilege that, you know, I do have a, you know, great memory of that. So I decided to do another decade album for my next song. And this is one of my favorite bands. I've seen these guys at Headbangers Ball headlining back in 03, when Headbangers Ball was still relevant. They still had Jamie Casta for a damn host, you know. And it was still, you know, they even had CDs, compilation CDs, Headbangers Ball compilation CDs.
Right, I remember that.
Yeah. I mean, that was when it was a great show. It had some push, you know. These guys here pretty much had the staple headlining gig for this tour of Headbangers Ball. Lamb of God. We all know them, we all love them. But this album here is what really put them on the map. This is As the Palaces Burn. This is a fantastic album. This is the one that really turned me on to them. It got me on to the fact that I got to see these guys, because they're just one of the top bands of our, especially '03. That was the band that really put the metal back on the map for a while. I mean, they changed things. They made it so unorthodox at the time. such a different aspect.
Well, it was pretty fresh. I mean, yeah. for a band that was gaining a lot of exposure, I mean, compared to everything else that I was paying attention at the time, I mean, they were definitely a big sort of
something,
you know?
Certainly cutting edge.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, I figured, what the hell? I want to play that first video I ever listened to. Man, I love it so much. Everybody knows the song is terrible or whatever you want to call it.
No, that's actually, that song is about alcohol.
Is it alcohol?
Yeah. I know the video is it's like war footage and stuff. But the song is actually about alcoholism.
Okay.
From what I've gathered.
Okay. So. That does make sense. But you see the guy sitting in his chair and have that damn